Hi guys, here is Ivan with yet another tutorial. I will create a portrait of this beautiful girl I did few weeks ago. We are going to speak about colors, principle of a portrait, skin tones and much more. So if this might be interesting for you, don't go anywhere in the next few minutes, we are right about to start. Just before that, let me tell you something new. In the last video I mentioned that I will start a mentoring program where I will give to some of you one-to-one contact with me and I will personally coach them. Because of the big interest and the reason that I will start with a very limited free spots at the beginning, I've decided to open two more triggers to the program where each and every one of you can apply and take part in it. I've created a Patreon account where I am going to make completely different content than the tutorials in YouTube. I have opened also a Discord chat where we are building a community with tattoo artists all over the world, including me of course. There we discuss together our daily questions. For the premium version you will have also a separate critique section where you can post your work all the time, and few times a month I am going over all the works in a special video and I'm gonna give you a constructive critiques and some advices on how to improve it. This is just a portion of all I'm planning to do for you, so please be patient. If this sounds interesting, make sure you check it out. I will leave all the infos in the description below. But now let's dive into the tutorial today. As always, let's start from the beginning with why I chose the reference for today's tattoo. The customer wish was a portrait in colors and she showed me some examples of faces that she likes. Most of them were girls with long and very beautiful hair, and I've decided to use this as an eye catcher when I'm searching for a reference. Actually, what is more attractive than a girl with the fire red hair? As you know, I like to bring as much emotion as possible with my art, and I guess this portrait brings immediate reaction to the viewer. However, before I start to speak about the process, let me share with you what my needle configuration is for this tattoo. I'm using my favorite Stigma rotary spear tattoo machine and as always the cartridge needles from Fadron. I have 3 round liner, 7 round shader, 7 magnum soft edge and 13 magnum soft edge, all by 0.30mm long taper. If you don't know what this means, I have made a separate video for you. Just go into my channel and check it out. Okay, once you know the tools I'm using, let's have a look on the hair and what kind of colors I have prepared for it. At first place I'm going to need some bright red for the most part of it. Use the colors that are allowed in your country and what makes you feel most comfortable to work with. As you can see, this is one of the only questions I don't give an exact answer on because I don't want to focus on brands in my videos. I don't really know where you came from and what you're able to use. However, there are 3 major brands in my opinion, and those are Eternal, Intense and World Famous Ink. Almost everything they produce is high quality and the rest is just in your hands and taste to choose the best for you. However, for the shadow part I will be using a really warm dark brown color. This you can achieve by adding a bit of pure black to your red, or if you buy a pre-mixed one and add it to your palette. Then you will need some beautiful bright orange for the highlights, which of course you can mix yourself by using a tiny bit of the red, what you already use, with some bright yellow in it. And actually, those are my 3 colors I will be using for the complete hair. Simple and effective. As my idea is to make the hair really powerful part of my tattoo, I will be using a highly saturated colors for it. Let's make a short deviation here. If you don't know what a saturation is, this essentially means the intensity of the colors. In other words, saturation changes just how gray the color is. It doesn't change the value, it doesn't change even the color itself, just the intensity. For example, as less and less saturation you have into the color, as more and more grayish it becomes, till on the end is completely desaturated, which means just a pure gray. However, I'm using a high saturated colors as I want to make my hair stand out and grab the attention of the viewer. Now let's have a look how I choose my skin tones to stay in contrast to the hair and not that all look like one thing on the end. As you can probably guess yourself, I try to keep my skin tones a bit more desaturated, which basically means they will have a less intensity. And this directly will make the hair even stronger eye catcher and will separate it. For me, the first question you should ask yourself when doing the skin tones is what kind of base color you would like to use. And by this I mean that you should ask only one simple question. Is the face I'm going to tattoo more pinky or maybe more brownish or whatever you want to make it look like? Once you know that, it will be much easier to make yourself a palette related on this particular tone. Anyhow, I've decided to make mine a bit more pinky and pale, because in my opinion it works best with the ginger hair. Now, this doesn't mean that I will be using just different light and dark pinks to create complete face. No, if you pay closer attention, you will see a lot of different grays and even some greens in the shadows, as well as some brown. Like always, I have started with the darker part of the face, and in this case I suggest you to do it as well. First reason is because the skin tones we are working with are very light and clean colors, and if you decide to darken some of them later on the process, will be quite easy to dirty them up, which is not the result we are want to end up with. Second reason, an actually common mistake that I see many artists do, including me from time to time, is to make the face too light everywhere and on the end to look flat as hell, without any forms and structure. I suggest you to start with some pretty dark color in the beginning and slowly to make your way till the lightest spots. I recommend you to go a slightly darker than you anticipate it to be. It is always easier to go from darker to lighter than the opposite. Remember that skin tones are just a variation of different desaturated colors. On the end, there is not such a thing as right or wrong color. The most important thing is how they communicate with each other and the relation between them. I always try to do a good harmony between different colors and not just to pick one and fill the complete face. Like this, the portraits start to look rich. The reason why I prefer to work with a limited palette is because in there almost nothing could surprise me anymore. You don't need to be a graduated art school student to understand how the colors communicate with each other. I'm a good example for this, because I have never been in an art school or university. I just have a passion to draw and paint, and this brings me here. I have watched every tutorial in YouTube and I try almost everything by myself in practice. With the time, it all starts to become somehow natural and you start to understand how it works. The rest is just fun. Of course, with the years, I build up the knowledge on how to make it correct and so on, but the truth is that we all can do it. We just have to learn the basic principles and then to experiment till you find what works the best for you. I hate when people say that I'm lucky to have a talent for this stuff. For me, all what the word talent means is just 90% passion and 10% hard work. And of course, I understand that there is some really small portion of people that are superhumans and have the ability to learn or do stuff much easier than others, but I speak in general. I don't really want to go too deep in this tutorial on the skin tone mixing and color harmony, because first, the tutorial will go way too long. And second, this tattoo is not exactly the best example that I can show you everything what I'm speaking about. Take this as a basic guidelines on how I make a skin tones, what I'm searching, and try to understand the principles on how I build the portrait in general. In the future, I will definitely make much more detailed video on this topic. However, if you don't want always to wait till I make the tutorial you are expecting me to do, feel free to send your application to my email and apply for my mentoring program. Currently, all the free spots are taken, but I'm planning to open new very soon. There you will have direct contact with me and we will work on what your specific needs are and how to improve your skills. You can also join me in my Patreon. We have a small community of artists, including me of course, where we discuss our daily duties and share some cool content. You can also go for a premium tier where few times a month I will make a weekly critique and you can send me your work. After reviewing it, I will comment it in a special video with some tips on how to improve it as well. It is a lot of good resources there, so make sure you take a look. I will let all the info and link in the description below. So again, make sure you check it out. Here in YouTube I will continue to make these tutorial videos for you, where I will share my experience and try to make your way a bit easier, learning by my mistakes. You can subscribe to my channel if you still aren't and hit the small notification bell, so you can be notified always when I post a new video. This way you will never miss anything. As always, have a great day or night, depends when you watch the video, and if you have any other questions, please let me know.